So here we go. Today, another session on building leaders, the book that I've been working on. And y'all are a good excuse for me to have to work on it every week to get a session ready for you. Today, I want to talk to you about decision making. If you're going to lead yourself or others, you have to make decisions. And this book, of course, is based on my Uncle Don, who was a home builder. And building a house is filled with decisions constantly. I mean, the whole day is filled with decision after decision after decision. And on the job site, there's no evading the decision making. You have to constantly decide, is this the right thing to do? And my Uncle Don, who was a master builder, would do that. And he would make decisions, you know, constantly because we had to on the job site. So, he would say, now, where's the water going to go? If we do it this way, where's the water going to go? Or will this be strong enough to hold up the second floor? Or will this header span this distance that we're talking about spanning? All of those decisions had to be made. And the key to building a house, it's real simple. Each decision you say, each decision has to be made based on one principle, which is, will it build a better house? Well, as you as a leader, as you as a business owner, whatever your role is today, every decision that you make has to be based on, will it build a better life for me? Will it build a better business for me? Will it build a better organization? And yet, out here away from the job site, all that gets blurry because we end up doing things that waste our time, that don't produce and don't move us towards our central purpose. And we've talked about central purpose before, but I want to bring it back up. The central purpose of building a house is real simple. While we're on the job site, we have one mission, and that is to build this house. We have a blueprint, and its only purpose is to build this house. But when we get off into sales or we get off into running other organizations, we realize that you get sidetracked by so many things. How should I spend my morning? What should I be doing first? How should I be, should I work on this? Should I work on that? And the phone rings and emails come and let me just drift along through the day and maybe something will get accomplished. Mm-mm. Decisions have to be made to focus on your central purpose, to accomplish the central purpose of your life, or the central purpose of your organization or your business. And when you begin to drift, as my mother used to say in high school, she would go, son, you're drifting. You're drifting. You're not focused on your homework. You're not focused on your sports. Whatever your central purpose is, you're just drifting. Well, you can't just drift. You have to focus. And if you focus on your central purpose, now here's the problem. Most of us haven't identified our central purpose. And if you haven't identified your central purpose, then anything you do will be fine. My mother, when I was in high school, we used to have in the newspaper, they would cut out a little thing called Today's Chuckle. And she glued one on my mirror in my bedroom, and it said, on the road to success, there are many convenient parking spaces. Along the road to success, there are many convenient parking spaces. And in our world, because we don't want to make decisions or because the decisions we make aren't crystal clear to our central purpose, we just park. I'll just park here and study emails for a while. I'll just park here and not do anything productive. I'll just park here and maybe the world won't run over me while I'm here. Once you clarify the central purpose of your work, central purpose of your life, central purpose of your whatever your organization is. And if you're a leader, if you're going to lead others, your only job, the only job that leaders have is to clarify the central purpose of this organization. So it was real clear on the job site with my Uncle Don because we're building a house. If suddenly we just started changing tires on cars, everybody would go, what the heck are y'all doing? Your homework, your job is to clarify the central purpose of your day, of your life, of your business, of your organization. Now, it's a book on leadership. So if we're going to deal with leadership, we have to deal with self-leadership and we have to deal with leading others. And if you're going to be a leader, your job is to empower the people you work with to think and evaluate and decide how to solve problems on their own without you holding their hand. So your job as a leader becomes to empower others to make decisions. Now, as soon as you do that, everybody freaks out. Well, what if they make the wrong decision? I'm their boss. I'm responsible for it. Or people on your team make the wrong decision, make the wrong choice. Well, making the wrong choice happens all the time. And if you make the wrong choice, guess what? You just get to make another decision. Now, when it comes to other people making decisions and making wrong choices, there are two factors as a leader and with yourself that you need to follow. Here it is. When errors are made, when decisions are made that are wrong, and those decisions are made incorrectly because of lack of skill, lack of knowledge, you can never fault another person for that. When someone doesn't have the knowledge or skill and they're placed in a position of making decisions and they make the wrong decision and it's the fault of lack of knowledge or lack of skill, not a problem. We can teach you. You can go to class. You can learn. You can learn new skills. You can learn new knowledge. So when decisions are made incorrectly due to lack of knowledge or skill, teaching must occur. I watch basketball. I'm a college basketball fan, and I love to watch the college basketball coaches. With 9 seconds left on the clock and somebody makes a bad decision and they come out of the game, the coach is teaching them with 9 seconds left in the game what should have occurred. They're teaching them a new skill. They're teaching them more knowledge. That's your job. Oh, and you got to teach yourself. If you are making decisions that are incorrect because of lack of skill or lack of knowledge, then you need to go back to school. You need to take more classes. You need to learn to be better at your business. You're better at your skills, better at your life, whatever you're working in. Now, if decisions are made through lack of judgment, when all the facts are there and someone makes the wrong decision because of lack of judgment, that's a whole different story. Because when the facts are there and you can see the facts and they still make the wrong decision, that's a lack of judgment. And my experience in life is you can't fix that. If you're leading a team and someone constantly makes the wrong decisions based on their judgment, that's a moral, that's a value-driven, that's a belief-driven decision that you can't really fix. You'll have to find someone who can make better decisions to replace that person on your team. Now, decisions come a couple of ways. The first thing is we didn't ever talk about how you make decisions. Well, decisions are easy. First of all, you have to think about the problem. Second of all, you have to evaluate all the facts. And third, you have to decide. And then take action. In today's society, and our next session is going to be about emotional decisions, because in our society today, all decisions seem to be made based on someone's emotions. Emotions have no place in building a home. No place. Two by fours don't have emotion. Nails don't have emotion. Whether this wall will stand up is not an emotional decision. It's a factual decision. But more on that next time. Decisions have a process. And the U.S. military, I work around the U.S. military some, and their decision-making paradigm is real simple. When you have 75% of the facts say, do it, do it. You'll never get 100%. So I want to break that down a little further. When you're making decisions for your life or for your business, there's three questions you should ask. The first is it even possible? Now, I do business coaching, and I work with agents all the time who want to set goals. And I've been amazed at the number of goals that are set that just are not possible. I sold 3 houses this year. I'm going to sell 300 next year. That's not possible. It's just not possible. If the evidence in favor, if it says, well, it's possible, there's evidence to say, you know, there's nothing that'll stop you from selling 300 houses a year. Okay, then it is possible. Second is it probable? If a substantial body of the evidence says that supports your conclusion, but you still don't have the ability to, is it probable that this will occur? You can move forward. Now, I'll take you back to the example of somebody that sold 3 houses last year and wants to sell 300 this year. All right, show me the information that's going to change your world. Show me the decision-making paradigm. Show me the marketing. Show me the facts that say you can do that. And if there are facts, then it becomes probable. But the last piece is it certain? And certainty says that every piece of available evidence points to a single conclusion. All the data, everything says this is going to happen. Nothing suggests a separate conclusion. Okay, there's no room for doubt. Make your decision. The real estate industry right now is in turmoil. Well, most of it is. Because no one has the facts. But if you start to study the facts, it gets real clear where our industry is going and how it's going to change. And then you simply make the decisions that take you to that inevitable future. It's real clear where we're going. The trick is, have you gone far enough to make the decisions? Now, leaders must make decisions all the time. Uncle Don building a house had to make decisions constantly throughout the day. The best use of manpower, the best use of resources, the best use of materials. And will these decisions lead us to the central purpose of our building the house? So leadership decisions form what I call the leadership pyramid. And the basis of all leadership pyramids is knowledge. If you know enough, you'll know what to do. And if you don't know what to do, you don't know enough. In the turmoil that our world seems to be in today, learning is the key. Learning more about what's going on in the industry is crucial. But we just want to fuss them. We just want to talk about it. We just want to spend time, talking about the turmoil. Instead of entrepreneurs have a central purpose. Building a house is real simple. Building your business is real simple as long as you're focused on it. Now, this decision-making pyramid First of all, you have to say, on the basis of all the facts, on the basis of everything that we have learned so far, of any decision that you have, with all the factors so far discovered, this is the right decision. This is the proper conclusion. But then most people never look at the information again. I made my decision. I'm moving on. What if there's new information? There's new information occurring in our world constantly. And you must constantly be reading and evaluating new information. And how does it fit into my decision-making pyramid? If it adds to my knowledge base about this industry, then I add it. And as you build the pyramid up and up, you realize more and more pieces of information are added, and you become more and more of an expert. Knowledge doesn't contradict later knowledge unless some fabulous discovery is made. We understand gravity. We understand going to the moon. We can add to that knowledge, but it doesn't change the fact that gravity exists. The more you discover, the more knowledge base of your decision-making pyramid you have. Discoveries move you from general knowledge about an industry or an organization or whatever you're trying to accomplish to a more specific, increasing, detailed expert knowledge. And here's where I lose most realtors. They got a license. They started selling houses. That's what they know. Instead of studying their industry, instead of learning constantly, expanding their knowledge, my wife and I always laugh whenever I'm speaking. The best always sits on the front row, and they're always there. They're always learning. They're always growing. They're always changing. The rest of our industry is like, I'm good. Well, the problem is, the world is constantly shifting. And as you add more knowledge, as you add more data, as you add more facts to your world, you begin to realize that what you knew in the past wouldn't carry you through today. I think it was Einstein that said, the thinking that created today's problems will not solve them. We have to think in a different way. Now, I want to come back to emotions, because when you have a decision to make and it clashes with your emotions, then you have to take a pause and decide not to follow the emotions. Emotions are like road signs. They're not giving you the road. They're not telling you where to go. They're simply saying, hey, here's a road sign. And if you got off the highway at every exit, every road sign took you off the highway, you'll never get to your destination. That's what emotions will do. You don't make decisions based on emotion. You make decisions based on the facts. And if you're having to make an immediate decision, absolutely, it has to be made on the facts, not on the emotions. Because emotions will hold you back if you let them. There's one other point I want to make on decision-making today, and that is this. You have to make your own decisions. Decisions are not a group thing. I work with boards and committees all the time, and boards and committees never, ever make decisions. Only you can make a decision inside the sanctity of your own mind. And your decision-making has to be based on, this is the right thing to do, based on the facts as I understand them, without regard to other people's feelings. Oh, can't do that. It might hurt somebody's feelings. Well, you're going to miss the opportunity or make a bad decision. Groups don't make decisions. Now, if you and I have a disagreement, and I have more facts or knowledge, or you can teach me, and we can both chew on it and learn more together. But the key is, only one person can make a decision. And most of the time in committees and work groups, boards of directors, we end up with consensus, but we don't end up with decision. If you were going to build a house today, you'd go get a blueprint, and you would clearly understand your central purpose to building that house, and you would start. My advice is, let's go back and define your central purpose, either in your life or in your business or in your organization, and now define it clearly through a blueprint, and that becomes your central purpose. And anything that gets in the way is irrelevant. Decisions are always made to lead you to the success of achieving your central purpose. I'm Zan Monroe. And that'll take care of us for today.